everyone, I'm Rongji, and today I'm going to show you how to generate and analyze Wi-Fi 8 signals using Keysight software toolkits. Wi-Fi 8 is coming, and it's a game changer, so let's dive right in. Here's what we'll go through today. First, a quick overview of Wi-Fi 8 and how Keysight supports higher physical layer testing. After that, a hands-on demo on generating and analyzing Wi-Fi 8 MU PPDU and TB PPDU signals. Wi-Fi 8 is all about reliability, while Wi-Fi 6 and 7 focus on speed. Wi-Fi 8 is built for consistent, deterministic performance, perfect for XR, industrial automation, and e-health. One of the biggest upgrades, smarter interference handling. It uses multiple AP coordination, better spectrum management, extended range, and improved power efficiency, or to ensure a smooth, reliable connection. The IEEE 802.11bn standard is expected to be finalized by 2028, but we'll probably see early devices by late 2027, just like Wi-Fi 7. Wi-Fi 8 builds on Wi-Fi 7, but goes beyond just speed. Here's what's new. First, new MCS values for better rate adaption. 2. On equal modulation UEQM for more efficient MIMO. 3. Non-primary channel access for dynamic switching. 4. Distributed resource units DRU for more range and power efficiency. 5. Longer LDPC calls for stronger error correction. 6. Multiple AP coordination to boost network efficiency. Now let's talk about testing Wi-Fi 8. With Keysight Signal Studio, N7617C and XApps, you can accelerate development from R&D to manufacturing. These tools help test components, receivers, transmitters, and even MIMO setups, whether you are using benchtop or modular instruments. And here's the best part. Keysight toolkits already support IEEE 802.11bn Draft 0.1 version, so Wi-Fi 8 RF testing is ready to go. Let's walk through some of the key Wi-Fi 8 signal generation features using Signal Studio. Wi-Fi 8 builds on Wi-Fi 7 EHT PPDU, but now uses a physical version identifier to differentiate it. In Signal Studio, you will find a quick setup page for 802.11bn PPDU. Just config settings and you are set. Next, let's move to the new MCS values. 802.11bn introduces 4 new MCS levels to fine-tune the signal-to-noise ratio sensitivity. You will find this in Signal Studio's MCS index menu. Now let's move on to the unequal modulation. In MIMO, different streams can use different modulation levels. Just set multiple spatial streams, and the Signal Studio lets you fine-tune the UEQM settings. One of the biggest features is Distributed Tone Resource Units, DRU. It is used in the TB PPDU frames only. DRU boosts transmit power by spreading tones across a wider spectrum. In Signal Studio, just set the RU allocation index and toggle the distributed bandwidth. Next, let's take a look at longer LDPC block codes. Wi-Fi 8 doubles LDPC code word length for better error correction in low signal environments. This option is easy to enable in Signal Studio settings. Finally, let's take a look at Enhanced Long Range ERR PPDU format. It uses fixed 20 MHz in 2.4 GHz for uplink and downlink. In 5 GHz and 6 GHz band, it's uplink only. Signal Studio has a dedicated UHR ERR PPDU option to create these frames easily. For signal demodulation, XApps N9077EM2E now supports the 11bn radio format. It can demodulate UHR MPPDU and TV PPDU frames. With UHR TB PPDU frames, you can edit RU allocation to analyze both regular RU and distributed RU usage. MIMO demodulation is also supported, including UEQM for the Wi-Fi 8 signals. To sum it up, Signal Studio N7617C lets you easily generate both Wi-Fi 8 and legacy Wi-Fi signals, covering almost all physical layer features. XApps 2025 provides detailed analysis and demodulation of Wi-Fi 8 and legacy Wi-Fi signals as well. Keysight is fully equipped to support Wi-Fi 8 RF testing today. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website. Thank you for watching.